Welcome to this week's News Bulletin Roundup. Here are the headlines. Canadians who have Afghan spouses are pleading for expedited visas. New Zealand goes into a national lockdown over a single case of COVID-19. Three people are dead and 50 are wounded following a bombing of a Shia Muslim Ashura procession in Pakistan on Thursday, August 19th. United Nations rights experts are demanding that the Eritrean government release the Swedish Eritrean journalist Dawit Isaac. Three Afghan politicians are resisting the Taliban, openly risking their lives. A British man has been sentenced to 6 weeks in prison in Singapore for refusing to wear a face mask in public. Wildfires continue to advance throughout Northern California. Many Afghan Canadians are fearing for the lives of their dear ones back in Afghanistan. Since the Taliban took over in Afghanistan, a spokesperson for Canadian Immigration Minister has stated that Canada is prioritizing family reunification applications for those Afghans who are immediate family members of Canadian citizens and permanent residents. In New Zealand, Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern plunged the country into a national level 4 lockdown, the highest level of restrictions, as New Zealand announced its first local case of Delta variant. When questioned about the strict restrictions, the Prime Minister replied with one word, Australia. The state of New South Wales struggled to contain its outbreak, that week having 8,000 active cases. In Pakistan, a deadly explosion at the Shia Muslim Ashura procession in the city of Bahawalnagar has left three people dead and at least 50 injured. While the exact motives and perpetrators for the attack are unknown, Ashura, the holiday that largely marks the beginning of the Shia sect of Islam, has been the site of much sectarian violence by the hardline Sunni Muslims against Shia Muslim in Pakistan for decades. While police presence was high at the procession, the roads were blocked and deadly attacks were unable to be stopped. In Eritrea, one of the longest imprisoned journalists in the world, Dawit Isaac, remains in custody after 20 years without a charge, trial, or ability to speak to his lawyer. The UN rights experts are demanding that the government release Isaac, a dual national of Eritrea and Sweden, are fearful that he may no longer be alive. Isaac, alongside his colleagues, were arrested in 2001 after he published articles demanding political reform in Eritrea. In Afghanistan, some forces are still trying to resist the Taliban, specifically Zarifa Ghaffari, Salima Mazari, and Fawzia Kufi, who are vocal proponents for the human rights which they say the Taliban threatened. Although the Taliban has stated that they are going to rule peacefully and allow women to access their human rights. In Singapore, a British man has been sentenced to 6 weeks in prison for refusing to wear a face mask in public. Benjamin Glynn has been convicted of four charges, including failure to wear a mask on a train, at a court appearance, causing a public nuisance, and threatening public servants. Glynn maintains that the charges against him are unlawful and argues that he should be returned to Britain immediately. The Singaporean judge, however, disagrees. The judge argues that Glynn is completely misguided if he believes that he should not have to follow Singapore's mask laws. Finally, in Northern California, United States, wildfires have destroyed two mountain communities. Even worse, these wildfires are continuing through Sierra Nevada Range. Fire officials estimate that at least 50 homes in the area had burned since the fire started on Saturday. Moreover, two people have been hospitalized with serious injuries. The Dixie Fire is the largest wildfire out of 100 major wildfires burning across the western states of America. That's all for today. Keep watching the International News Channel. I'm Julia Cosby.